Good morning, children. Today, we will revise chapter 2. In this video, we will revise exercise, objective type question. So, open your book, chapter 2, exercise, objective type question. Question number A. First, SI unit of density. SI unit of density is kilogram per meter cube, because we know that density is equal to mass by volume. SI unit of mass is kilogram and SI unit of volume is meter cube. So, mass by volume, kilogram by meter cube. So, SI unit of density is kilogram per meter cube. Option is given A, gram per milliliter, B, gram per centimeter cube, B, C, kilogram meter cube, and D, kilogram per milliliter. Liter. So, answer will be C, kilogram per meter cube. Next question, whether an object sinks or floats on water depends on, floats and sinks depends on density of water and the substance which is drawn or which is float. Answer is given density of water, true. How dense an object is, also true. Amount of water displaced by an object, this is also true. So, all of these three A, B and C are correct. So, here answer will be D, all of these. Whether an object sinks or floats on water depends on density of water, how dense an object is, amount of water displaced by an object. So, answer will be D, all of these. Next, to calculate the volume of an irregular object, we need to first add initial volume and final volume. No, subtract initial volume from the final volume. So, this will be answer. Subtract initial volume minus final volume. And C, subtract final volume from initial volume, none of these. Initial volume means volume of water and final volume means volume of water plus the body. So, answer will be B, final volume minus initial volume. Subtract initial volume minus from final volume. B will be answer. Next, density of irregular solid can be measured by irregular solid, volume of irregular solid can be measured by Eureka cane. This is true. Eureka cane, we can find with the help of Eureka cane volume of irregular solid. Measuring cylinder is also true. No. So, we can find with the help of measuring cylinder also. And C is written both A and B and D is written none of these. This means that answer will be both A and B, because we can find volume of irregular solid with the help of Eureka can and measuring cylinder. So no problem. Okay. Next. Next question. Which of the following hydrometer is used to check the battery is fully charged? Answer is given: lactometer. Lactometer is used to find density of milk. Acid battery hydrometer. This is the instrument which is used to find or to check the battery is fully charged. Base battery hydrometer, no. Hygrometer, no. So no problem. And next question: which of the following are more denser than other? We know that solid, liquid or gas. There are three types of substances: solid, liquid or gas. Solid is more denser than liquid and liquid is more denser than gas. Okay, no problem. Generally. So, here answer will be solid. Solid is more denser than all liquid and gas. Next, which of the following is less denser than water? So water, less denser, this means that it floats on the surface of water. Lead is metal, it does not float, it sinks. Aluminium sink, wood does not sink, and glycerin also sink. This means that wood is less denser than water. Less denser than water. Next, which of the following is the SI unit of relative density? Relative density is the ratio of two similar physical quantities. So both units can be cancelled and it has no any unit. So SI unit of relative density is none. So answer will be D. First is given kilogram, B meter, C kilogram per meter cube, and D no unit. Relative density has no unit. Answer will be D. Next question: which of the following factors affect the density of a substance? Physical state, temperature, pressure, all of these. Listen, density of a substance depends on physical state. Solid, liquid, gas, this means that it depends on physical state. Temperature, yes, because temperature increases, volume increases, and density is mass by volume, so density depends on temperature also. And pressure, due to increasing pressure, volume decreases. Gaseous substance and liquid substance, volume decreases. This means that what will be happen when physical state is changed, temperature is changed, or pressure is changed, density of the substance is also changed. So answer will be all of these. Next question, fill in the blanks. Number one, the density of a substance is the ratio of its mass and volume, because relative density is equal to mass upon volume. So answer will be mass. Next, the density of fluids is more than that of gases. Density of liquid is more than gas. Next, the relative density of a substance is the ratio of its density to the density of water at 4 degree Celsius. Relative density is equal to density of a substance upon density of water at 4 degree Celsius. So, it is clear? Next, on cooling, the density of gas increases because on cooling, volume of a gas decreases, volume decreases, density increases. Next, a body of density 3.5 gram per meter cube will sink in water. Why? Because density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube and the body having density 3.5 gram per centimeter cube, which is greater. So, greater density means sink. On multiplying the relative density by 1000, one get the density of the substance in kilogram per centimeter cube. Relative density is multiplied by 1000 and you will get density in kilogram per meter cube. Next, write true or false. So, see, salt water is denser than fresh water. Fresh water, salt water. Fresh water contains salt. So, density of salt water is greater than fresh water. True. An object with less density than water will sink. Less density, float or sink? Not sink, float. So, answer will be false. Solids are less denser than liquid. Solids are less denser than liquid. False. Solids have greater density. Cooking oil is lighter than water. Cooking oil is lighter than water. True. Next, if we take two cubes of the same size but of different material and weigh them, they will weigh same. No, different material, so different density and so mass will be different. So, this will be false. Mass of an object can be easily measured using a Eureka can. Eureka can is used for finding the volume of the irregular object. So, this is false. We can measure the density of irregular solid by knowing its mass only and not volume. False. Because we need both mass and volume. So, this is false. A Eureka can is a container with a spout near its top. So, it is correct. A spout is just near the top of the can. So, it is true.